How about y'all? Peace, 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 peace. What's going on? This is a special video that the ancestors told me to make. And I'm going to tell you why the ancestors told me to make. Excuse me. So the ancestors told me this. Chocolate Amun Ra, I need you to bring out some point of views. I want you to bring out some point of views and open up some eyes. I want you to be blunt and speak the truth. Because we're not walking on this earth being honest with each other. We're sitting here just coming up with all these historical history, which is great. But we're not truly being honest with ourselves. I'm going to break it down. Before I do that, let's pay all due respects to the Creator, because without the Creator, none of us would be here. The sun rises. Assalamu alaikum. Good morning. Amun. All right, brothers and sisters. First of all, you take adversity and you transform it into something positive. Because if you don't do that, it's gonna literally sit here in your mind and corrupt you. Let's move that out the way. Now, what I want to discuss this morning is this here. How people are not who you think they are. How people can sit up here and tell you and preach to you. Listen to me now. Listen to me. Because I'm about to blow your mind away from the bullshit that people do on a regular basis. Preachers, pastors, conscious community, all these institutions. I'm about to blow your fucking mind away. And this is how you catch people and what they're really doing. It's not about degrading. It's about if you truly believe in what you believe in. If you truly believe in what you believe in, understand what I'm about to tell you. To be truly blunt, most of you do not go outside your communities. Let's keep it real. You go as far as you can go shopping. Shopping. Most of you will not go outside 5 mile radius. And at 5 mile radius, you're going to go shopping for clothes, food, and whatever accessories you need. Right? Okay. Most of you will not go into a white neighborhood or any other culture neighborhoods because you're going to feel very uncomfortable or out of place. Think about what I just said. I don't care who you are. Okay? You're not going to catch no Hebrew Israelite in an Italian neighborhood preaching what they preaching. Think about this for a minute. You're not going to catch no Hebrew Israelite going to a Chinese neighborhood and preaching what they preaching. It's easy to go into a multicultural type atmosphere or area. They say, hey, because I live in New York, and they'll go in Manhattan, which every culture that's passing through, and then they start to preach it. But go directly into an Italian neighborhood, go directly to an Irish neighborhood, go directly to a Russian neighborhood, and start preaching. Oh, excuse me. Go directly to a Jamaican neighborhood, or a Haitian neighborhood, or a Dominican neighborhood. Go directly to there where you notice is 90% of that culture. Let's start talking. Okay? Now, you ain't gonna find no religious group will do that unless they have an Italian Jehovah's Witness, Italian Moor, Italian Hebrew, Italian, Christian. All these religious groups will not go into another culture's background, backyard and start preaching. Come on now. Come on now. I don't care what religion you're in. I don't care what institution you're in. You're not going to go into that Italian neighborhood. You're not going to go into that Russian neighborhood. You're not going to do that. Tell me if you've seen it. So everybody's so cool. We love each other. We love this. No, you're not. You're going to go where it's safe. Even in Africa, when you get like some of these famous preachers, they're not going to just go into any part of Africa. Don't let them fool you, brothers and sisters. This is not to sit up here and downgrade anybody. This is fucking facts, man. They got to send somebody over there and make sure that part of Africa is safe. Because if you go to the wrong part of Africa, you're a dead motherfucking man or a woman. And they know that shit. You go to China with that same description of you want to preach. You go in the wrong part of China, you're dead. That's facts. Any country you go to start preaching your shit, and you think that people are going to stop and listen to you, you might not come back home. You go to Brazil, any one of these rainforest countries, these lands, and stop preaching. You in the woods. They ain't got no problem of fucking executing your ass there. Let's get this. Everybody want to talk about we Hebrew Israelites and we this. Not to just be talking about them. We Jehovah's Witness. We this. We that. But you will not step in to all out country that has not been fed that information. You have to have one or two or three people that can speak that language and be able to dialogue with you. Because if you don't, you're taking a risk. How many missionaries that went to these different foreign lands and how many of them did not come back? All right? Let's stop playing games. Nobody wants to look at it in this type of angle. Okay. Let's take another further step it up. Most of you do not want to communicate with other melanin people. Facts. Most people don't want to communicate with other melanin people, such as Dominicans, Puerto Ricans, Mexicans, Jamaicans, most of the island people that lives here in your state or live here where I live at. Okay? Let's be real. You do not go out your way to greet these people from different islands and different countries. You will not. You will not. You're not going to say good morning to that African. And African most likely ain't going to want to talk to you. He's so goddamn arrogant. He going to be like this. Get your fucking coffer. Your fucking coffer. So let's see if some of you educated people know what coffer is. I'm not going to explain it to you. I'm going to see if you know. Okay? And African people gonna call you a kafa, and most of you don't know what that means. Okay? Wrong African, you're gonna taste some of that. Now, what you don't realize is all these people are melanin. You figure because they speak a different language, oh, you're not black, you see? You go on the color code text black. You're not black. You don't know your heritage. You don't know who you are. You see your skin is not even black. It's a brown tone. Even like, look at this here. Look at this. This brown here is darker than my skin. The brown here on my bracelet is darker than my skin. So even if you go color code text, you still wrong. You're in the brown family if you want to play color code text. But my main meaning is this. You don't know who you are. Who are you? Another thing. So you can state you love your peoples. You love that. Let me ask you this question. Who is your people? I just gave you a little example. Who is your people? I'm going to tell you what. I'm going to break this ice real quick. You only know your immediate family. Here we go. Your father. Maybe one or two cousins of a generation. Your father, his brother, or sister, if he has family. His cousins. You probably only know maybe one or two, third or fourth cousin. You do not know fifth, sixth, and seventh of cousins. You don't know that. Most of us don't know. We'll know our first and second cousins. But when it gets to three and four, it gets real thin. Real thin. And if they come to that family reunion, when the last family reunion you had, that's why family reunion was so important. And so you can know who your people is. Family reunion was based on all the family coming together as a tribe and knowing from the left side and the right side, which is the mother and the father. When the last time you had a family reunion? Family reunions, because you don't know these people on either side, especially when it comes to the third or fourth generation. You don't know nothing else but your immediate family. And every year that passes by, it's to get thinner and thinner. And I got another thing for you. But we seem to not to talk about. You know how many kids, male and female, that has been adopted? I knew I was going to get you on that. How many millions stranded children, millions of kids has been adopted? You don't. What family? What culture? What country? And if they were adopted when they was an infant, and if that family don't tell them where they come from, and most likely they probably don't know, only the immediate family, or that mother or their father that left that child, or the mother couldn't take care of that child, or some people who pay for a child. So we are so thinned out. But at the end of this lecture, most of you, and I mean most of you, and I'm not going to give you a statistic because I'm not mathematically can be able to clarify that, but I can say most. And I'm saying most of the people around me and what I see and hear, and most of the people that you know, you can see and you can hear. Let's be truthfully. Let's be bluntly. You don't give a damn. You don't give a damn about it. You don't care about it. I know it, and you know it. You're worried about going to work, getting your paycheck, what you're going to buy this weekend, how far you're going to get drunk, how much smoke you're going to be smoking, and who you're going to be fucking. You ain't worrying about your ancestors. You don't care about that. You might be curious. It might give you a little trip. But let's keep it clear. You worrying about is going to work, get your money, get your fuck on, get your high on, and you repeat the same cycle every week. And then at the end of the year, you go, I got to make a new revolution. I got to make a new revolution. I got to change. I got to lose weight. I got to stop fucking all these people. I got to start smoking drugs. I got to stop doing dope. And the minute a little pressure hits you, fuck that. I don't care. People love me who I am. They don't love me. Who cares? That is reality. That is the truth. You know it. I know it. And stop being phony to each other. Because that's all it is. you're lying to each other, and you do it all the time. You hate the fact when somebody put that in your face, which most people do. You hate when somebody bring reality, and because you don't want to hear it. I don't blame you. Shit. You don't want to hear nobody telling you how you supposed to feel. How you supposed to feel? Don't want nobody telling you nothing. Right? So, this is what you go through. So here's my thing to you. Then I'm out.
Now brought to the rhyme face from the scroll straight to the verse. God to God, so God's to man. Many kings, many leaders, a fist from a hand. They call me militant. Now what does this mean? Do I carry a gun? So let the army see. All the cause will never pause. Assembly of the brother. Raise the flag, wave the colors. Red, black, green with the key. The difference. Words make a way in the world. In an instant. Willing to die and I die to live again. 360 degrees.
Think.
Comprehend. A man getting stronger till he's mad no longer.
Don't. Give a damn. That's facts. That's real.